Hey everybody, welcome back to another Permaslug episode. My name is Jonathan with Apex Web Solutions, and today what I want to do is walk you through something that I've been working on for quite a while, and that is getting Material Design Lite incorporated into Oxygen. Now, if you're not familiar with Material Design Lite, you're looking at the current homepage of their website right now, and basically it's a framework from Google with a bunch of different icons and buttons and all kinds of different elements that are styled to be really accessible, mobile-friendly, easy to use, and in the Material Design Lite case, it's designed to be set up with almost no code, so you don't have to worry about JavaScript or anything complex like that, which in our case is fantastic because it means that you can incorporate it into Oxygen with really no hassle whatsoever. There is a newer version. Material Design Lite has kind of been, not pushed to the side, but you know, it's secondary to Material Design Web, or MDC as they call it, and with that, there's a lot of JavaScript involved. Not really as simple as getting this working, but there really is nothing wrong with Material Design Lite. It's not deprecated, it's just not actively being updated, but it still does work perfectly fine. So with that in mind, if you're already a member on Permaslug, if you go to your account page, you're gonna notice a new tab, and as you can see, it says Material Design Lite. There is a key there for importing a design set into Oxygen, and that will give you all of what I'm about to show you, and basically set everything up for you. So all the headers and the buttons, the classes and the styling, etc., will all be there for you to take advantage of and incorporate them into your website if you so choose. If not, that's okay. The other thing to keep in mind is there is this getting started guide. You can see that orange button down there. And what that will do is take you to a Google Doc with a ton of different notes, all the classes that you would need. So if you want to start setting up these buttons and all the different elements manually in Oxygen once you have the code in place, then you can certainly do that. This is also very much kind of a test sort of beta for me, so I would really appreciate any feedback. And also, if you know, if there's something that you're having difficulty with, I'm not really going to be able to provide support on this. It's more just me. I actually built this because I wanted it personally for a different project, and so I thought, why not turn it into a design set and share it with you guys? So in any case, what we're going to do now is walk through all the different elements that you'll get when you add your design set to Oxygen. So this is the sample website that I was talking about. So this is the design set that I've set up, and keep in mind this URL is probably going to change. So if you go to this URL, it may or may not be live, but this has almost everything that I've built for this particular design set accessible and visible, so you can check it out and get an idea of what's there and then decide if you want some, all of it, none of it. It's up to you. So first of all, this is one of the headers that comes with it. So this one is actually a fixed header, and it's a little bit confusing because fixed and scroll, I think most people refer to as like a scrolling header is what you're seeing right here where it stays at the top of the page. They actually call this a fixed header, and then the scroll header is the one that stays kind of sticky at the top of the page, like it doesn't follow you down. So it seemed a bit backwards to me. Maybe it's not, but in any case, you are looking at the fixed header. Now again, because all of this stuff is built in Oxygen, all of this is divs, text links, standard Oxygen components with the MDL classes on it. So MDL, of course, being Material Design Lite. So all of the class structures start with MDL, and you'll see that in the Getting Started guide. The other really cool thing about these headers is they have this slide-out drawer. You could use this to create kind of a dashboard feel because there's a class that you can apply to this drawer that keeps it open all the time, and then the background is not grayed out. What's cool about this is that on the mobile devices, the navigation here will go away, or you can have just a little bit of it. You know, maybe you have like an icon or something that stays visible, and then this drawer will kind of take over. So on mobile devices, the drawer becomes effectively your navigation. I do want to reiterate the fact that I am a bit hesitant to call this a design set. Realistically, this is more of a framework, as you can see right here. I said that's just a quick way to put together a site that looks pretty decent and is built on a well-organized framework, but I really wouldn't call this a design set because it's not like there's a bunch of pre-built like heroes and pricing tables and stuff like that. It's more foundational elements like headers, footers, buttons. I mean, you can see all this stuff up here. Some of my favorite stuff that I'm excited to show you is things like the grids and then tooltips, tabs, and then like the menu component, which is this little like pop-up guy right here. So these are really cool because you can add kind of a contextual menu. I'm sure you've seen these across other Google properties on the web, especially on mobile, but these are really cool because they're, again, just built using divs, and these are just basic text blocks. So you can make pretty much anything fit inside of these little containers, which is cool. Scrolling down, the first thing that we have, this is the button section. So these are called FABs, floating action buttons, as you can see. You can set these up to be pretty much anything, and all of these have an icon from the Material Design Icons library, so they can all be customized. You know, down here is basically just a FAB with the vertical dots icon, and these are just the plus icon. So this one on the left here is just a plain button, and then on the right it has that ripple effect like you can see, and it's just the different examples of all of these buttons, large and small. The other thing is that these colors come from a primary and accent color that you set from MDL, which you can see in the Getting Started guide on how to change that. And then if you don't self-host the CSS, if you manually copy and paste the CSS into your site, then of course you can override the primary and accent colors, but I just use the provided CSS and use their little color picker tool, which I'll show you later, and then this is what we were left with. Moving down, these are all the different buttons that it comes with. So you have just like a regular plain kind of like gray button, and then the same thing with a ripple effect. You have your primary color button, the accent color, and then the accent with ripple, and all of these can sort of be interchanged amongst each other. So flat button with ripple, flat button, primary flat, accent flat, etc. So those are your button options. Moving down the page here, you have the MDL menu, which I already showed you. It's the same thing as this over here. What you're looking at is the MDL menu right there, and then also an MDL menu here. So these are super flexible because you can control the direction in which this MDL menu opens. So it can be at any corner on this little icon here. And so that's how this one opens to the top left or top right. Not exactly sure which one that one is off the top of my head. And then this one would be bottom left or bottom right. Icon buttons are basically just an icon that has that little hover effect and then the little click animation when you click on it like that. So those are great for, as you can see, like a login or logout button. And then you can also expand these to be tooltips, which I'll show you later on. Some of the pre-built cards that are included with MDL is this wide card. So these are perfect for like, you know, a blog archive or like an events listing or something like that. It also has this nice icon up here. So you can do this with like a social share or, you know, something else, some other icon there. There's the same card, but just smaller, what they call a square card instead of wide. Another example here with image and event cards. So you could have like the dynamic file name or a caption here. And then these are the same things, but just effectively in a grid. So we'll get to grids in a moment because those are super awesome. But it's basically just those cards are stuffed in a little grid. Tooltips are super awesome because they are basically just a little bit of information when you hover over an icon. So you have the small and the large tooltip. And then you also have multi-line tooltips. So you can see same thing, but then the large format too. So you can do multiple lines. And these are just icons with an extra div attached to it. And then you can put whatever you want inside of that hover div to make it show, you know, right there it says the word print, but you can change that. And then of course you can change the icon itself. You can add color, etc. Pretty cool. So these are some of your layout options. So again, what you're looking at is the fixed header on the top of the page here. And don't worry about the fact that the WP admin bar overlays this. It doesn't happen on the front end. And to that effect, there also is two scroll bars, but that only happens when you're logged in. On the front end, you know, to a not logged in user, non-admin user, it doesn't happen. So you have the fixed header with the drawer, which of course the drawer is this thing right here. And you can set that up to only be visible on desktop and or mobile, depending on which class you apply, or you can set the drawer to go away completely. But that's of course not super ideal because that becomes your menu on mobile. Scrolling header is effectively the same thing, except it just stays at the top of the page. It doesn't follow you around. You also have the tabs header as an option, but these are not really compatible. So unfortunately you can't set the tab header to inherit one of these other two because those tabs are kind of tied into the header component. So you would have to set this as its own template in Oxygen and then build out the content inside of the tab, which is not super ideal, but you could also just set this template to apply to a particular page if that page is super content heavy. Or later on, I'll show you how you can set up the MDL tabs as kind of a standalone element inside of your page content. MDL also comes with a mini footer that's super simple. It's two divs to make a little one row footer like that. And then the mega footer is a little bit more useful. You know, you have the four columns and then an extra row. It's basically just these four divs and then the mini footer stuffed beneath it like that. And then the style guide is pretty self-explanatory. It gives you like font sizes and line heights and stuff, which I go into more detail in the Getting Started guide about that information. So don't worry about agonizing over the details there. All of that is handled for you using the MDL code that they give you. This is the primary and accent colors I was talking about, the customized colors. So if you go there, you basically pick a primary color and then pick a secondary color. And then it gives you the CSS code that you simply replace in your main template in Oxygen. And then it changes, you know, your header and your accent buttons to be whatever you want. So if brown was your primary, it gives you the available colors that they recommend based on accessibility, you know, just readability in general. But you can play with this to your liking. And then also, you know, if you decide you want to override it, you can certainly do that. Moving back to our example here, I probably need to move this body links up to the little style guide information, but there is that. Box shadow is pretty cool too, because that's handled for you. You basically have this one class, MDL shadow. You put the number in there, DP, and that gives you the kind of intensity of the shadow. So those are your options, 2 up to 24 in those increments that you see there. And then there's the example of what that box shadow looks like. So these are great for like cards, you know, images, divs, basically anything. You can apply that shadow to pretty much anything across your entire site. This touches on icons a little bit more, except this shows you how to increase the size of the icons. So you have basically 4 steps of icon size, and you just simply add that to the very basic icon class code. MD18 gives you this size, all the way up to MD48 to give you that size there. This is also a link, which is in the Getting Started guide to the material design icons. There's a ton of them, and anywhere that you want to change the icon, all you need to do is look at the name, like app_blocking, and then all you gotta do is just change that in your code. Basically, right here where it says face, that's what's making the face pop up right here. So you would just change that to app_blocking, and it would change the icon for you. Super simple. So now I've moved over to the grids page, and this is pretty similar to some other frameworks. You might be familiar with the idea of like an up to 12 kind of cell grid like this. But what's cool about this is all of the responsive features are handled for you, so you don't have to worry about setting up the divs to be responsive and collapsing at different breakpoints. That's all done for you. And because it's built using Oxygen divs, you can put anything you want inside of it. What I've done is gone ahead and built a number of grids that you might want. So there's a typical 1x12. That's as many cells as you would put, you know, in one single row, but then you have the other options, 4+4+4, 4 wide. You can see these other options on the page there. The other cool thing about this is they don't necessarily have to add up to 12, and if they don't, the spacing in between the cells is handled for you, which is really neat. And because of the classes, which I'll jump back up here real quick to show you, you can build your own layouts of any arrangement. So all you need is one div, which is MDL grid, then every cell has the class MDL cell, and then MDL cell X call, and the number X is any number between 1 and 12. And again, they don't have to necessarily add up to 12, and then you can build your own layout. So like this one would be, you know, 1x12 would be MDL cell --1-call would be this particular cell, and you just repeat that out, you know, 12 times basically. And then these would be MDL cell 4-call for each of those. If that doesn't make sense, check out the Getting Started guide and you'll see more what I'm talking about there. What I think is so cool about these grids is all of the responsive features are handled for you. So even if you don't touch it, it will kind of collapse and work perfectly fine on mobile. But the other thing that you have is the ability to change how they kind of fall at different breakpoints. So these two look very similar, but the alt behavior is a little bit different on how they collapse on mobile. So let's jump into the inspect tool and I'll show you real quick. So if we kind of start collapsing this page, what you'll see once our screen width gets small enough is things start collapsing. So if we scroll up here, we're at 1x12, and now you can see it's starting to collapse. Looks pretty clean. The 4x4 starts stacking on top of each other. This 642 is basically fitting to the full width of the page, and then this 642 alt is a little bit different. It's keeping that 4-column width and then the 2-column width for much, much longer until you start to shrink, and then eventually they all kind of stack on top of each other. The way that you achieve that is by another class with the word tablet or phone or desktop or whatever you want at the end of the class. Again, check the Getting Started guide and it is in there for more details, but it's just pretty cool the way that all that is handled for you. So if we scroll down to some of these like the 282, let me collapse those a bit, and you can see this one keeps its 2 wide, then it jumps to 8 and then 2 and so on. The Getting Started guide goes into more detail on what each kind of device can have in terms of its maximum. So on the desktop, you know, you can have up to 12 cells. On tablets, I think it's 8, and then on phones, it's 4. So you can kind of see how you could control that layout a little bit more. But as it starts to collapse, eventually everything's going to get pretty close to full width. So in any case, I just love the way that the grids are kind of handled for you on the responsive side of things. It's really great. The other thing I wanted to show you was the tabs component. So this is very similar to the inbuilt Oxygen tabs, except it's just styled to look like material design. These are just built using divs, so it's pretty basic, but you have a simple tabs component. And then With a little bit of tweaking, you can set it up to be vertical. And then, you know, on mobile devices, if you have a bunch of different tabs, you would definitely want it to be vertical. But that all works perfectly fine. And you can do that using the oxygen breakpoints in the mobile devices selector window. So that's what's so cool about all this stuff being built is in Oxygen, is you have control over everything. What I want to do now is just jump over to my sandbox install, and I'm going to show you what it looks like when you have the design set added. So in your WordPress install, just go to your Oxygen settings here, go to the library tab. I typically turn off default design sets, but that's up to you. You just need to enable third-party design sets and then click on add. In the site key here, this is what I told you earlier, to go to your Permaslug account page. And as long as you're a member with an active account, you will have that site key in your account there. Under the material design tab, you just paste that site key in here and click add source site, and then you're good to go. Once you've added that site key in there, you'll see that it says Material Design Lite is added to your site. And the first thing you're probably going to want to do is go to your template. In my case, I have this site-wide template, which I'm going to edit with Oxygen. So I have this super basic header builder and inner content, which I'm just going to go ahead and remove. And then let's go to add. We're going to go to the library, click on design sets, and go to Material Design Lite here. And then you'll notice that some of these have screenshots and some of them don't. The screenshots are super clunky. For some reason, they just like don't really work in the block library, which is kind of frustrating. So unfortunately, some of this stuff you will kind of have to scroll over and read it. Sorry about that, but unfortunately, there's not much I can do. In any case, you just go to the header section, or if you're editing a template like we are, you'll have this templates option and you can pick fixed header with mini footer or mega footer. Or you have the scrolling header with mini footer or mega footer. That is quite a lot. So we'll go with the scrolling header with mega footer right here. So everything is going to get added to Oxygen for you. And let's walk through how some of this is set up. So first of all, you have this code block here, and this has the material icons code in it. It has that CSS code in it. And this is the line that you would replace if you use that color customizer to change it. So, you know, it's going to give you that line of code. You just simply need to replace the second one. And then last but not least, there's a little bit of JS, but that's all you need. There's nothing else in terms of code. So this particular div right here contains everything you're looking at on the screen. So if I expand this, you can start to see everything is named for you. So it should be pretty easy to understand. The MDL layout header is this header with the row in it. Then of course you have your header row. In this case, I have a heading, which is basically just pulling in the current page title. So it's using the Oxygen dynamic data. You have this MDL spacer, which basically just pushes the content on the left side and the content on the right side, space between, that just pushes them out as far as it can go. And then you have your MDL navigation div here with just simple link wrappers inside of it. So of course you would just set your URL and you're basically good to go. The other thing you have is your MDL drawer, which is of course that slide out drawer. The only thing is that in Oxygen, you can't really see it, which is kind of annoying. So you have to go to this header right here and you just basically have to add the class for the drawer, which is MDL layout fixed drawer. And then it pops open and you can see it right there. If you don't have an inner content element on your page, you'll have to go to MDL layout content and like just basically set a height temporarily. We'll just go like 1,000 pixels or something like that. And then you can mess with the content in this drawer. So I'm just going to get rid of that. And then we're going to go back to our header here and just remove the drawer class like that. So inside of the drawer, you have all the stuff in the structure pane. That's what you were just looking at as the heading, again, with the dynamic page title, basic link wrappers, and then we can minimize this stuff. The MDL layout content contains your page content. It's one div that has the Oxygen inner content element in it. So you can just use a typical page like you normally would with the inner content in your template. And then this is the MDL footer. So pretty basic layout. This is the top part with the four rows. And then this is the second row down there. Once again, it's just two divs basically. Very, very simple. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and save this. I'm going to go back to the WordPress admin panel. Let's go to pages real quick, and then let's just go edit our homepage with Oxygen. So now, like you would normally expect on a page when you have an inner content element, you can just go ahead and start designing the content of this particular page. So in your library, there is one hero included in the Material Design Lite library. So let's just go to sections. We'll go heroes and just throw this guy in. The reason why I included this is because this is just a simple layout that kind of pushes the content into the rough middle of the screen. And this is using the MDL cells kind of classes that we were talking about earlier. So the div has MDL cell and MDL cell to call. And then this one here has MDL cell 8 call. So this is responsive for you just to demonstrate what that looks like. It's just going to collapse and everything looks perfectly fine. The other thing I wanted to do was just go back to some of the content here. So there's a bunch of grids. Again, sorry about the fact that the screenshots aren't showing up. I don't really know what to do about that because sometimes the screenshots work and sometimes they don't. But you have a lot of those grids. There's the MDL tabs. You can see those are mostly the grids in there. And then in the blog section, I have a number of blog archive templates for you. So there's the archive templates of varying sorts. They're available for you. You have individual footers, the headers we already covered, and then the hero here. But if I go back to the material design Lite, click on pages, then what you can do if you want an individual element, like let's say you want some buttons, once everything gets loaded in, that page is just going to pull in all of those different buttons that we looked at earlier. And what I would recommend you do, if you're going to use these a lot, is one of two things. If you click on a given button, these are all built using link wrappers, and you can basically just take a look at the classes on them, and that will replicate exactly what you want. You don't have to do anything to the link wrapper. You don't need to set colors or typography, spacing, nothing. All of that is handled through the classes for you. Again, if you take a look at the Getting Started guide, you'll find all the classes for all these elements there to achieve the look that you see here. But the other thing that you can do is on a given element, you could realistically just make it a reusable part and then add it to your page as an editable element to save you a little bit of time. So I'm just going to save this real quick. We're going to take a look at this on the front end, and then I'm just going to inspect this real quick, show you that everything still does work on the mobile devices. Very simple. Again, this is not so much a design set, more I would call this like a framework, but hopefully this is intriguing to you. This is a project that I was working on kind of for my own benefit, and then I thought, why not share this with you guys and see if anybody has interest in it? Hopefully you do, and please definitely give me feedback on the permaslug.com contact form, and I would love to make improvements to this and grow it over time. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in a future video.